Hi there.
So, been asked recently, how do I get the proportions so right on my HotWheeLs hot rods that I'm building? I guess this has to do with many factors. And what is right, okay? This is what is right to me, and I'll explain how this happens and how I go about it and what I like. So first of all, I also don't always get this right immediately. I usually start something either intentional and think I want to build this and that. I want to build a truck, or I want to build something. I see something on Trog, on YouTube. I see something in Pendines, in Britain, and the hot rod races, something that inspires me, something that I like. And then basically, usually what these little toys are, is just me thinking towards a real car. And therefore, you know, this is not what I spend all my awake hours thinking about, but they help me to exercise the proportion of the vehicle. And sometimes these things stew away so that they take like years to pass before I go back to them and find actually what actually is wrong with what I was doing before. So let me get something to point. The last one I built, or shall I say mocked up, is this one. It's the 32 Ford, and interestingly enough, I built this one first and I used the Ford's engine because I felt this bone shaker so delicate that this engine was too big. So this, I think this engine is more in proportion with the X bone shaker, and I don't really like the bone shaker, the skull head. Has nothing to do with me, for me, with modifying a car and making it a hot rod, but that doesn't matter. Okay, so anyway, this I think is still is a brilliant car, and at first I was taking offense with the angles of the cab until I realized that I can work with them. So when it comes to proportions, what is important to me is that this thing is as short as possible. We're talking about two people sitting in there. I don't need more than that. And I like a stretched out and low look to them. And if I would go about it, the logic, okay, how to get it as low. So basically the body sits on the ground, more or less, with a couple of millimeters to spare, so it actually still runs. The rear axis is as far forward as it can be, so that the door still opens. That's more or less the same in both of these cases. Am I actually filming something that you can see? Let me double check. Let me make sure you see what I'd like you to see. Yeah. There you go. So let me get to the point here. The formula that I found for myself is that we have a cabin with two people. They sit as low to the ground as possible. The rear axis is far forward as it makes sense proportionally. In this case, we're talking about a door shut line, and then there's the wheel. Similar here, we're talking about a door shut line here, and the wheel is right there. So actually the wheel is right behind the body, so slightly needing to be further back on this car than it does on this one. Whereas this one has an obviously a correct already this is already a top chop model, so therefore we're low enough by the time I channel that, so this is way lower than the actual hot wheel used to be. Also the rear wheel is bigger, the front wheel is much narrower, and so on. And I obviously looked at how do they really look like. They usually have these massive brake discs in the front. So I'm going to make a disc by cutting these caps in half and put a thinner axis. But these are all details, okay? So this is basically my formula for proportions. I like it that you sit in there. Then this is the gearbox. So basically the gearbox is a cap, still missing in this rod. I'm going to put that in there eventually. Engine and then front axis, and in between also still missing here the radiator. So to me this is kind of like what a hot rod should look like. So this is a very good example in my books. And then this one also, this one still lacking the gearbox. This is a bit more natural. Both of them didn't need any paint on the body or aging in my books. So this is what I made out of these. And I just felt I want to do another one. So I started with this toilet thing car here. They call it Gotta Go. And you know, it has a toilet in the back, which I think is stupid, but whatever. So it gives us a usable cabin. Whereas there's one serious problem in this cabin, that's why I don't like it, it's this stubby nose. It's not my style. So basically, I need to move this grill forward to about there. Also, the front axis needs to go here. And then there's space for an engine, and the rear wheel can move forward quite a bit. So basically, I think we don't need this part at all. I don't think it makes sense to work with this chassis. It really is no need. I'm making my own chassis these days. So the cabin sits about there. And yeah, something like that. And then I make a short bed. Much shorter than this bed was. Yeah. Okay, so let's get working on this. Get this out of the way. I think the front wheel is gonna detach, yes. On these two hot rods, there's a little bit more information. I made short videos of them before. If there's any questions you guys might have, please go for it, ask away. So here's the bed. So let's do first things first. I need to start somewhere and I need to use the time that I have. And that's not much, because I'm doing a lot of things and not just little cars. So I'm going to first of all file the stacks away, because I don't like those. That's not my thing, and I need something to prevent my table from getting scratched. So let's get rid of these stacks. I think I can do this with a shot and more of a tool. I'm just gonna file them off. Hey, I have a question. Can anyone shed lights on why this kind of cars, they had flat roofs? They just use a piece of wood and stick it on there? What's the history of that? Enlighten me, please. So, getting rid of the exhaust stacks. Gonna be less of a truck and more of a hot rod. I'm leaving the front on because I can hold it easier. It's so hard to hold it. I'm envisioning this flat roof to be a piece of wood that will be covered in fabric. So I just painted matte black. I don't think I'm going to go through the effort of cutting a hole in there. The bone shaker already has a hole, that's fine for me, so I'll leave this one closed. I do not want to hurt the roof surface, so I'm very careful. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do today. And then I'm going to cut the grill off without damaging the grill. A hood's toast here, it's not important to me. So I'm staying clear. I want to keep the natural shut line using quite a monstrous saw for that. And then also I will go straight down from here later using the roof as a guide. I'm going to keep a little bit of bulkhead. Okay, so, and one more action. Once I removed enough material and I'm getting too close to the old surface, I will go with a file. And then I will go with a less aggressive file, and then I'm going to use 240 sandpaper on the sanding block, and then probably we'll get rid of the stacks here as well. This way. You know, in this business, you have such little parts to hold on to, so you need to make sure you make it as easy for you as you can. I'm going to keep as much of the original paint job as I can. There won't be much left, so I'll be just on the doors. When you do this, you can always check how even you're working. And I always tend to turn the part around so that it evens out, sort of like my body's habits of being single-sided. And I can continue to check. So well, this goes relatively nicely. This is a very sharp, very high-end file. I think this is B&Q Great Britain. To go as far as the roof. As soon as it touches the roof, I will stop. Touches the roof on the top. Getting there. Need to put a little bit on the left side. Now you can see that I'm getting to the cast marks. These I will take away. Cast mark I don't want. for the tool. This is too small, really. Yeah, but it will be okay if we kind of work clever. Okay, not much more. Want this cast mark completely gone. Don't like cast marks. Always puzzles me. People actually taking the paint off, but they don't fix the cast marks. Why bother? That's more important than taking the paint off. We are almost ready with this action. Almost. Yep, I'm going to conclude it now with sandpaper. That's all of it for now. I think I'm not sure whether I'm in the picture, so let me move it over there. So that should be that. Remember, this house in one piece will never be as convenient again for me to work on. So let me do things as they need to be done. So I'm gonna call it a day though for this side. And now I'm going to finish the top. So we're dangerously close with that tool, so I stop. I stop. Nothing harder than a mistake you made. Okay, so that'll be the roof flat now. Okay, that's my roof to perfection. And now I will need to do something about this. So I'm giving it a bit of a radius, that will help, okay, that's that. A bit of a radius this way too, and that way. Let's call it a day. Done once it's cut apart, but that does it.